you know, how we do it. Another feature here is we have a DNS spoofing feature. So I can actually go in and say that, you know, when people search for, like, Pathfinder, redirector to this IP instead, or just Google to this IP instead. So if I'm on this device, now I'm trying to go to, like, if I go to Pathfinder, I have to get to this site instead of God. So I can have to redirect them, and if I go to, in some cases it works, if I go to Google, I should end up at the site and go to have a search engine. So I can, you know, redirect them to different machines, so I can actually try them to do, get them to Facebook, or, you know, if I go, if I try them to Facebook, I get them to my page, I can see them to log in and continue from there. So if I'm in the middle, I have full control over your traffic, and where you go to and what machines it is. So, I mean, I think that it's not so fun. It's actually a pineapple buffer. So, you can actually download add-ons to it. So you can get, you know, jammers and DNS spoof and NMAP and NMAP scanner. You can get keyloggers and I will inject a keylogger into a page that you view so I can see what to type and other things. Even Java and all that. Sure, it's fun to have. Just cookies and other things. So, it's a bit. And if even, you know, you can add a 3G modem longer than a USB one, you can actually get a 3G on the box as well. You know, walk around the city and start recording. So, in my shop, you can see all the requests here being made. And I don't know if anything fun right now, but no. If you are patient and you're lucky, I'm sure you can find some good stuff. So, I will not, you know, hack you off now, so it turns off. You have to keep you safe for the rest of it. For the evening. So, what's next? So, I can inject JavaScript. And this is really interesting because if I can get my own JavaScript into a page, I have a full access to everything that you as a user have access to in the browser. I can see your cookies, I can see your, I can, you know, look at keyboard typing, I can, in some cases, get, you know, if I have Java installed, I can start accessing your hard drive, if I can start affecting other machines inside your network or somewhere else. And so, I think, you know, let's do that. So, this is on my page. I start entering some beef. I'm still in the CNUs and just, you know, number and credit card and so on. That's good. I see nothing suspicious here. But if I, in a different browser, go to this site, my command and control center, I actually see this, my browser here connected to it. And if you, anyone else wants to try, you can actually go to this IP address, it's not dangerous. You can actually go to this address in your phone and, you know, see what happens. Because the thing that will happen is that, first of all, I can see what I was typing. I have a full log where I click on a page, I can see what I did as Manda and my credit card. I have full real time visibility in what I'm doing on this page. So if I go back to this page here, I start typing something, and I go back to this page and I check the log again. I see my types. So what is really happening here under the hood? If I go to Fiddler, everybody knows what's Fiddler, that's doing good. So it logs my traffic on the web. And you see here, it's kind of called the hook.js. It's my beef ordering page that is actually calling home to my command control server for an asking for, you know, things to do. So if you just constantly want to take them, then, you know, what should I do? So in theory, I can have, you know, on this page here, you know, hundreds of devices or browsers hooked to my browser. So if anyone of you would go to my beef page, you would actually end up here, and I could start seeing what is typed on that page. So that's, you know, that's good. But we are evil, so I can go to the command section, and then I can also look at, you know, commands that I can apply to a sensor browser. I can see if it works. I can go back here. So I have this, you know, links here. And we see that the first one here is go to beefproject.com, and a link to slash dot, hale.com slash dot, this link here. So, let's see. So I can actually try to place all links with something else. So I can replace it with, you know, manual protecting execute, and then a command to my browser. And by not doing anything, if I'm lucky, the links here should change. in real time. I'm not really sure if this will work, but I'm lucky. It should work. Or, it's not like it's working. But it's